Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. Today we'll be learn about one more important ecological concept, that is Bargmann rule. By knowing this rule, we can understand that how an one-blooded animal staying in colder climates can regulate their body temperatures. So let's start in details. The generalization that warm-blooded animals like birds and mammals having larger body size living in colder climates as compared to those of the same group or race living in warmer or hotter climates. And this generalization is known as Bargmann rule. We know that one-blooded animals have the capacity to regulate their body temperature up to certain levels, although their environmental conditions are suddenly changed. These generalizations are not true in case of poikilotherms. We see that in poikilotherms, they tend to be smaller in colder regions. The body size has played a significant role in adaptation to low temperature because it has influenced the rate of heat loss. The surface area to volume ratio in case of large body size animal is low, and this gives an opportunity to staying in low temperatures by maintaining their metabolic activity. According to the study of Brown and Lee in 1969, in large wood rats, we can see that a selective advantage received by these wood rats in cold climates because their surface to air ratio is low and greater insulation capacity permit them to conserve metabolic heat in cold climatic conditions. For this, the small size animals are favored in desert conditions because in case of small size animals, their surface to volume ratio is high, and because of this high surface to volume ratio, they have high rate of heat loss in extreme hot conditions, and this is the opportunity of small size animals staying in hot desert conditions. The rule is named after the 19th century a great biologist Carl Bargmann, who described the patterns of these generalizations in 1847. If we see here, we can easily observe that in equator or near to the equator, the one-blooded animals having small body size, while towards the polar regions, it may be North Pole or South Pole, the body size increasing toward the cold regions where cold climatic condition is available. Here we can see that the colder or cold regions in polar area, the one-blooded animal having large size body and they have surface to volume ratio is low, and this helps in maintaining their body temperature in colder climatic condition by reducing heat loss. In these graphs, you can easily understand if we compare the latitudinal variations with average body mass of moss, moss actually one kind of deer, we can see that those moss or deer living in near to the equatorial zone, they have low body mass, while those race of moss or deer living in towards the polar regions have increased body size. This is the generalization of Bargmann rules, that is, big body size animals, particularly warm-blooded animals, remain in colder regions compared to same groups or race living in hotter or warmer regions. Those animals remain in colder regions, their body size is big compared to the warmer or hotter regions. The temperature is one of the most important abiotic factors, and it has influence in many ways on animal beings. Temperatures affect the absolute size of an animal and the relative properties of various body parts. Surface area to volume ratio is vital in so many biological processes. Surface area to the volume ratio gets smaller as the cell gets larger. If we compare the different features of small animals staying in warmer regions with large animals staying in colder regions, we can see that the surface area is large in case of small animals and small surface area in case of large animals. And if you compare the volume, you can see that volume is also high in case of small animals living in warmer regions, while their volume remain low in case of large animals living in colder regions. And ultimately, if you compare the surface area to volume ratio, you can find that surface area to volume ratio is high in small animals while remain low in large animals. And this is the main funda, how large size help the warm-blooded animal staying in colder region by reducing their heat loss. If we see the rate of heat loss in case of small animals, it is high or faster, while the rate of heat loss is less or slower in case of large animals. This is the main basis how the warm-blooded animal can maintain their body temperature in colder region by reducing their heat loss, because they have been low surface to volume ratio. The examples of small animals staying in warmer regions like red birds and large size animals like polar bear, Arctic wolf are inhibiting in colder regions. Through this tutorial, we can learn then how an warm-blooded animal like avian and mammalian fauna can maintain their body temperature in adverse conditions. It may be too hot or too cold, and why the warm-blooded animal body size may be larger in colder region in comparison to warmer region of the same groups or race. This is all about Bargmann rules. I hope that after watching this tutorial, you have no doubt of any part of this concept. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, then like this video and share to your near and dear ones, and also hope that you will subscribe my channel. Thank you.